Yo, yo, yo. This is Envious Allied, and this is going to be a quick Scotty overview as well as some clips at the end of the beginning. So we're going to just go over real quick her abilities, what to max out, what I max out, how good she is, etc. So her passive is the wolf. It's basically she doesn't really have a real passive. Her passive is just more of the wolf, and explains the HP points, the attack speed, the movement speed, and the damage, etc., that the wolf can take, which is the wolf can take up to 5 auto attack or ability hits, and it regenerates HP over time. Has 2 forms, beast and elemental. Beast form is when you're attacking someone. Elemental form is when you're calling back your wolf into a passive kind of state. Has 2 stances, passive and attack stance, which is beast and elemental. There you go. Pretty easy. Great damage. Great scaling. This puppy does a lot. It's actually, it I think the puppy is hidden overpowered. We'll talk about it as we go through the rest of the kit. First ability, Piercing Cold, insanely viable in a meta all about pushing lanes and being able to poke people out. This ability not only slows does massive damage, etc. It's a fairly low cool. I mean, it's 15 second cooldown. It's up to a 40% slow, and it can full clear the wave at like rank 3 or 4, depending on what build you're going. So yeah, this ability kind of does everything. Kadir's basic attack deals double damage to targets affected by the Piercing Cold, which means that if you do hit someone with your Piercing Cold, your wolf does even more damage. So you want to combo it all together to do nasty, crazy damage. And I'll talk about the combos later on with this new god. Your 2 is Rune of the Hunt. Now, this ability you can get at level 1 without even putting a point in it. And this is basically being able to control your puppy, being able to control and send the puppy out to damage minions, any kind of minions. It could be jungle camps, lane minions, etc., even like Gold or something like that. And even if you get no points in this, it's okay. And we'll talk a little bit more about that. But really, to toggle this ability costs 0 mana, so you can toggle it as many times as you want. And it's really, I will say this requires a lot of multitasking. You have to pay attention to what the puppy is doing. You want to make sure that you know how much damage the puppy is going to take and know when to call it back so you can set it up for a good combination of abilities. Now, we're talking about the escape slash extra damage that she can do. Permafrost. Now, this is kind of weird. This is a new kind of crowd control. Not really crowd control, but it's a new effect added into Smite. Basically, it's like ice on the ground, and if you run over it, depending on which direction you're going, you slip and slide, and you can't control where you're going. You just slide forward. Pretty basic, right? This ability is decent at best. It's decent. It's a great late game, as when you max out this ability, the radius actually goes up, which is like it's pretty important. So it makes it look like you want to max this ability out. But we'll talk about double kipple a different couple of build orders that you can kind of go here to get the most punch out of your Scotty. But really, this ability is nice. But I think it's probably gonna need some tweaking. You get movement speed when you run over your ice patch. However, it's only when you're on top of the ice patch, and it's not big enough to really warrant any kind of crazy movement speed. I would like to see it probably buffed. Maybe you can have movement speed after you leave the ice patch. It gives you like a movement speed buff for like 5 seconds. I don't know. But overall, I think this item's just great, and I think it's just more of extra damage. She doesn't really have an escape. This doesn't really count as an escape. It's okay at best. Now, we're gonna talk about her ult, which basically is Winter's Grasp. Now, I personally like this ability. Winter's Grasp is it's really good. It has a nice root, especially when you get it maxed out to late game. It's an insane root. It's 2 seconds at max rank, crazy damage, and also makes your puppy overpowered. It's basically if you played any other game, like World of Warcraft, for example, it's like Beast Mastery when you kind of like go into like rage mode and your pet just grows red and goes out of control. It's the same thing. The puppy is literally immune to damage, does insane damage, can go out of control and kill everything. And I'll show you guys a screenshot in a second of like just here. Actually, I'll show it right now. So here's an example. This is actually before I was playing. And if you look on the screen, yeah, the damage, if you notice with this was all the puppy. The dash attack did 462, the basic attack did 308, Piercing Cold, which increases the attack damage, and Permafrost did 391. I died in a full combo to Scotty with no auto attacks. Notice how there's no auto attacks at all. She didn't auto attack me once. That was her whole kit. She spammed her face across the keyboard, was able to one-shot me. So I will say that her ability damage is insane, and she has a lot of potential, especially the way she is right now. The biggest thing is all about how you max her out and you're able to utilize her through early, mid, and late game. So we'll talk a little bit about leveling abilities. So there's two different builds you can do in terms of maxing out. The most common is you want to max out your, scrolling up, Piercing Colt, which is your lane clear. There's no point not to max it out. You want to max it out whether you go mid, solo, or dual lane as this new hunter. You need to clear. And in the meta right now is all about clearing the wave. You want to clear the wave and go from there. So max out the one. That's easy. Now you get a choice. You can level up Rune of the Hunt. So the benefits of leveling up Rune of the Hunt is rank 1, Kaldir gets a dash attack, which is actually pretty huge. The dash attack is like a little bit of a leap, and not even a leap, but it's just like boom, like crazy burst damage. You don't expect it. Rank 3, it heals him, and then rank 5, Kaldir's attack gives Scotty 10% increased movement speed. But really, as you max out Rune of the Hunt, also the puppy gains increased damage up to like, I think it's like 110% something. It's a lot. It's a big deal. You want to max that out second if you're going for a full damage kind of build. If you're feeling permafrost is your go-to, you can max out permafrost second. And what this does, increases the radius, and you can use this to kind of escape. You can use this for extra damage. It does damage over time as you lay it down on the field. So you might feel a little bit ballsy, set up a play, get a nice root combination, and then permafrost them. It can also be used for trolling. If the opponent decides to step up on you, you can permafrost them and put them completely out of position. This is a crazy, crazy effective in team fights, by the way, especially if you have the soul laner or the support and you just permafrost them on the ground, and they just slip and slide right into your team, and your team just dogpiles them. It's insane how useful permafrost can be in a team fight situation, but usually I just max that out for last. So my preferred build order is max out the 1, 2, and then 3, and then obviously ult whenever possible. But you can do it the other way around. You can max your 1 and then your 3 and then your 2. I just prefer the max burst damage. I feel permafrost, it's not going to save you in terms of escapability. The radius is nice, but against more experienced opponents, I don't think it's going to be a deal breaker. You want really just the extra guaranteed damage of the Rune of the Hunt. You want to abuse the fact that the puppy does so much damage. And yeah, that should be your go-to. So really, the bottom line about this character, no escape. You can very easily die, but the damage is insane. Going back to the screenshot, this is one example of just a late game or mid game Scotty doing crazy ability based damage. Will it be overpowered? I have no idea. Is there counterplay? If you don't have an escape or have no way to get away from Kaldir, you probably are going to die. Being honest, I was playing Artemis when this happened to me. You cannot escape. The puppy is fast. That's 110 extra movement speed. If you have no sort of jump or getaway or like a heavenly agility, you will die every single... The puppy will solo you, especially with the ultimate on. So you got to be very careful. She is a really good carry. Is she a hyper carry? Not really, but with the right abilities being used at the right time, she can combo someone to death. So we'll take a look at the next couple of clips, and I'll show you guys a couple of games that I had with her that I think were pretty notable. I have to get used to the pet commands, but I think we're good. I might quick cast the pet. Yeah, I think quick casting the pet seems really good. I might do that. I'll do that in lane. In the meanwhile, let's get her escape real quick. Bodied as fuck. Sunder boys. Alright, so we know that she has the damage. Or actually, that bitch was pretty low, so that doesn't really count. So this does. That's really good. Killed her pet. It's down for a bit. Neja on the side. We gotta pick Neja or poke him. But Ace Bear isn't here, so. Care.
I have a counter. They don't have any sentry.
Oh, 2v1, boys. Woo! Hey, let's do that goal, baby. Yo, 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 Pagan, 2 years. Yeah, you shouldn't. Let's just do it. I don't think you need to sacrifice yourself. Let's just team fight. Souls 3 is down. We should kill her ASAP now. There, he's frozen. He's frozen.
I'm going on study.
Alright, he's 1 HP. Yeah, get in there. Souls 3 is coming up. That's her 3. God damn, yo. Careful, Ice Spear. They're all up now. Wow. Robin's here.
Oh my god.
Oh, he's so low.
K Kona, dude. No, my pet. Got it. Thor's in the air. Watch out, guy. Alright, he dips.
Yeah,
let's push right.
We can just gank him, maybe.
No.
He's gonna be fucking darting though. Yeah, he's back in.
I'm going back mid.
Oh, baby.
Oh, baby.
Oh, baby.
No, my pet! Dude, he hit him! Wait, what? Slurp that what? No, no! No! Why do you guys put that shit on? The fuck?